How's it going, everyone? It is Andre Williams, and over here we talk stocks and we focus on one thing. Always protect your profits. Also got to put in the disclaimer, I'm not a financial advisor and this isn't financial advice. So just know when you do invest, you're doing it at your own risk. So today we're going to be talking about CTRM, Castor Maritime. I'm about to give you guys an update. So hey, let's get into it. So first, we got to go over the agenda. If you're new to this channel, I just want to let you know we have timestamps down below in the descriptions. But if you are a shareholder or you're considering to take a position, I suggest you watch this full entire video. So the first thing that we're going to be going over is a recent press release on the Castor Maritime website. Yes, we got a business update and we're going to go over it. Then secondly, we're going to be doing a technical analysis, taking a look at the overall price action. Is it looking bullish or is it looking bearish? We want to know what are those areas of support, resistance, and also if CTRM started to get bullish, what are those areas we want to look out for? And then we're going to be taking a look at the short interest information. Are there still a lot of short sellers that are in CTRM? Is the market sentiment still negative or is it positive? Well, we're going to find out. And then we're going to be doing the final thoughts after all of that is done. So let's jump into it. So we're on the CTRM website. We're going to take a look at their most recent news they just came out with. So Castor Maritime announces a new charter agreement and delivery of the MT Wander Muzika. CTRM, a diversified global shipping company, announces that the MV Magic Rainbow, a 2007-built Panamax dry bulk carrier following completion of its scheduled dry docking, has been fixed on a time charter contract, earning a daily gross charter rate of $25,000, commencing today with a term of between 7 to 9 months. The company also announces that on June 15, 2021, it took delivery of the MT Wander Muzika, the 2004 Korean-built Aframax LR2 tanker it had agreed to acquire as previously announced on April 30th, 2021. The MT Wander Muzika acquisition was financed in its entirety with cash on hand. So this is definitely a solid update to get from Castor. Like I was saying previously, we really need to see what the next earnings report really looks like, and then we can see where the stock actually ends up going. So we're going to do a technical analysis for CTRM. So let's see how it performed on the day. So it ended up closing at $2.94, being down 4.55% on the day. On the low, it tested $2.90, and then on the high, testing $3.08. And as you can see, what's going down inside after hours as of 5:16 p.m., it is at $2.98. So right away, the chart that we're using is the one-year daily chart. We want to have a good picture of how CTRM is actually doing. If we take a look at the RSI down below, it is definitely in that oversold territory, being right here at 34 points. So what I was saying in the last video for CTRM, where I see that there's more downward pressure in the stock, and that's exactly what we're seeing here. It is well below the 100-day, it is well below the 200-day, and it's also below the 21-day EMA. As far as where it's at right now, currently, where it closed at $2.94, yes, this is actually an area of support for CTRM. So what I'd be looking forward to see if it actually break through this particular area, maybe sometime next week, and get down here to around 260. Yes, you're seeing this clearly here, and if it pulls back even further, I would definitely make sure to have it on my watch list here. Now, one thing I want you guys to understand, and it's part of the reasons why I was telling you, do not add to your position as of yet, especially when they did that reverse split. The sell-offs are continuing. So I feel like this is going to continue even further. So if you are considering to get into this play, just know the risks that are involved and make sure you're prepared. And the only way this stock will begin to start looking bullish again, it would have to reclaim the 21-day EMA right here at $3.48 and have a bit more momentum to at least come back here to the 200-day at $4.21. If that's not happening, then this stock is going to continue to go down. So we're on Fintel. We're going to take a look at the short interest information for CTRM. So the short volume ratio is at 36%. So of course, a lot of short squeeze potential here, but there's also means a lot of negative market sentiment. What does this look like? So out of 4.2 million shares that were traded, 1.5 million of these shares were actually sold short. And this was updated as of yesterday, June the 17th. Short shares availability volatility stands at 1 million updated 22 minutes ago, and the short ball free rate is at 4.16%. If we take a look at the history of the short volume ratio, you can see it is definitely climbing higher here. Back on the June the 16th, it was at 29 and it's gone up to 36.20. It'd be very interesting to see what it is later on in the evening, but of course this is of no surprise as we've been taking a look at the chart. And of course, when they did their recent reverse split, that was not accepted too well by investors, and it's part of the reasons why we're seeing a lot of selling pressure, and it's why I do not want you guys getting into a position.
So for my final thoughts for CTRM, like I was saying in the previous video, please hold off before buying this stock. It is continuing on the downtrend that we spoke about. Ever since they did that reverse split, of course, this was not accepted well by investors. We also do need to understand that the CEO is very focused on expanding the fleet, and many are aware and they're being very cautious here. We have to take into consideration of the fact that he is not going to hesitate to dilute more shares. And I think many investors know this, and they know if they are in this play, it's going to take quite a bit of time for CTRM to actually come back and pay some sort of dividends. Not actual dividends, but I mean like profits, upside, and all that stuff. Another thing also to understand is the fact, yes, we're seeing improvements. They are expanding their fleet. This is great news. But of course, it's not really moving the stock much. Yes, we had a lot of volatility inside of the market today. But one thing you need to understand, CTRM really does need to prove itself to the market. Part of the reasons why there's also a lot of short sellers that are in this stock, being well above 21% for the short interest being around in the 30s, is significantly high. So CTRM is definitely going to have to show on the balance sheet that they're continuing to be profitable. We saw on their last financial reports, things were looking actually pretty good. So if they can follow that up with another report looking really, really good, then we can see this stock make a strong move to the upside. But just be aware of what the CEO's intentions are. His focus is growing the company, growing the fleet, and that's also how he gets the main base of his compensation as well. So if you're in this play, be aware of this, know this. I am not touching this as of yet. I feel like I want to see a pullback even further, but do know they are in the dry bulk shipping space. So taking this into consideration, if we end up seeing a strong movement in that particular sector, and as well as the economy recovering, CTRM should benefit from this. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we'll be talking real soon.